بيته الطيبين الطاهرين صلى الله عليك يا رسول الله صلى الله عليك وعلى أهل بيتك المظلومين لعن الله الظالمين لكم من الأولين والآخرين إلى قيام يوم الدين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إنا أنزلناه في ليلة القدر وما أدراك ما ليلة القدر ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. For the love of Fatima al-Zahra, صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. As we know, the Quran has tafsir and ta'wil. The tafsir is the apparent meaning of the Quran, and the ta'wil is the deeper meaning of the Quran. The ta'wil is the meaning of the Quran which we take from Rasulullah and the Ahlul Bayt, and the tafsir could be the event in which the verse was revealed in. And the Quran is not limited to just one meaning, because the Quran is for all the time. It's a continuous book. It's a living book. If you limit it to one meaning, then that means you have limited the Quran. And the Quran is not a limited book. So therefore it has tafsir, ta'wil, zahir, batin, am, khas. These are all ways of interpreting the Quran. Now, for Laylatul Qadr, the night of power or the night of destiny, in a hadith that is narrated from Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhi salam and Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq and other Imams, the Imams say, "Inna Fatima hiya Laylatul Qadr." Fatima, she is Laylatul Qadr, the night of power. And then the Imam says, "Waman arafa Fatima, waman arafa Fatima haqqa ma'rifatiha, faqad adraka Laylatul Qadr." And the one who truly knows Fatima and has the ma'rifah of Fatima, then that person will truly understand what is Laylatul Qadr. And then the Imam continues and he says, وَإِنَّمَا سُمِّيَتْ فَاطِمَةَ لِأَنَّ الْخَلْقِ فُطِمُوا عَنْ مَعْرِفَتِهَا. And she was named Fatima because the creation cannot comprehend the ma'rifah of Fatima. And then the Imam continues, he says, مَا تَكَامَلَتِ النُّبُوَّةِ لِنَبِيٍ حَتَّى أَقَرَّ بِفَضْلِهَا وَمَحَبَّتِهَا. And no prophethood of any single prophet out of the 124,000 prophets, no prophethood was complete until that prophet acknowledged who Fatima was. And then the Imam says, وَهِيَ الصَّدِّيقَةُ الْكُبْرَى وَعَلَى مَعْرِفَتِهَا دَارَةِ الْقُرُونِ الْأُولَى. And she is the صَدِّيقَةُ الْكُبْرَى. She is the ultimate truthful one. And through the ma'rifah of Fatima, life continues. This is a very great statement from the Imams. And many of us cannot comprehend these statements. And this is what the Imams say. لَأَنَّ الْخَلْقِ فُطِمُوا عَنْ مَعْرِفَتِهَا. Because we cannot comprehend who Fatima is. Now, what does it mean that Fatima is Laylatul Qadr? Of course, those who have the love of the Ahlul Bayt in their heart, they will ask Allah to increase their love for Fatima. And therefore, they will be closer to comprehension and closer to understanding the level of Fatima. Now some scholars, they've come and they've tried to analyze what does it mean that Fatima is Laylatul Qadr. One is that Laylatul Qadr is a night of secrets. There's so much secrecy in Laylatul Qadr. We don't acknowledge, no one of us can comprehend the magnitude and the power of Laylatul Qadr. The Imam says that the same as Fatima alayhi salam. Just like you cannot comprehend what Laylatul Qadr is, you will not be able to comprehend Fatima, because Laylatul Qadr and Fatima are full of secrets. This is why in the dua you say, Allahumma inni as'aluka bihaqqi Fatima wa abiha wassir al-mustawda'i fiha. I ask you by the right of Fatima and her father and the secret that is hidden in Fatima. So just like Laylatul Qadr has a sir, has a secret, Fatima also has. And then another interpretation is that Fatima, she represents the night, and the day is represented by the Imam, the apparent Imam. So she is Laylatul Qadr, and Laylatul Qadr ends hatta matla' al-fajr, until Fajr comes. So she represents the night, and Amir al-Mu'mineen represents the day. Another interpretation is that Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr. Laylatul Qadr, one night, according to Allah, according to the Quran, it is greater than 1,000 months. Similarly, if you have the love of Fatima in your heart, your salah and your sawm and your zakat and your a'mal will be multiplied 1,000 times. The reward will be multiplied if you have the love of Fatima, because if you have the love of Fatima, that means your iman is complete. That means your faith is complete. Another interpretation, Laylatul Qadr, one of the names of Laylatul Qadr in the Quran, fi laylatin mubarakah, a night that is full of blessing. Fatima was also full of blessing. She came in the life of Rasulullah, bringing blessing to Rasulullah, bringing blessing to her father, where she is the only source of the progeny of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Rasulullah had multiple wives, but all of his children, they are from Fatima, because she is the source of blessing in the life of Rasulullah, in the life of Amir al-Mu'mineen, in the life of her children, and in the life of all of the believers. Another meaning, Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. You know the Tasbihat al-Zahra. When you hold that Subha and you say 34 times Allahu Akbar, 33 times Alhamdulillah, 33 times Subhanallah, Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam, he says, Tasbihat al-Zahra is better for me than praying 1,000 rak'ahs. Do one tasbiha of Fatima al-Zahra, this is greater than 1,000 rak'ahs. Yes. This is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at your quantity. Allah looks at the quality of your action, the quality of your prayers, the ikhlas. And yes, when you do that, and you have the love of Fatima and the love of the Ahlul Bayt, your iman, every time you say Allahu Akbar, it will be worth much more. This is Fatima alayha salam, and this is just a drop in the ocean of who Fatima is. We cannot comprehend the status of Fatima and the stature of Fatima alayha salam. How is it that she became Laylatul Qadr? How is it that she was so great? Where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi ibn Abbas, he narrates, he says, one day Rasulullah, he drew 4 lines in the sand with his finger. And then he says, Sayyidatu Nisa, Ahlul Jannah are 4. The leader of the women of paradise are 4. Asiyah bint Muzahim, Maryam ibnatu Imran, these are 2 women before Islam. And 2 women after Islam, Khadija, and the 4th is Fatima. This is where the Sunni hadith ends. The Shia hadith continues and it says, وَفَاطِمَ أَفْضَلُهُمْ, and Fatima is the best out of them. This is Fatima alayha salam. Because you see, when you look at the life of this great lady, you see that she reached the highest potential of any human being. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not limit the human just because she's a female. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human being and gave the human being the ability to reach his or her highest potential, and Fatima reached her highest potential. You see that in every aspect of her life, Fatima was exemplary. Fatima was perfect. She reached perfection in everything that she did. And her life began as a daughter that made Rasulullah very happy. With her birth, she brought joy to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. She would show the love and the compassion to her father, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, because she was the gift from Allah to Rasulullah. Where Allah says, "Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar." We have given you kawthar. Fasalli li rabbika wanhar. إِنَّ شَانِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرُ. Your enemies who call you Abtar, Abtar is the one who does not have a progeny. Your enemy is the Abtar. And this is the reality, we see it today. Rasulullah, his progeny is amongst us today. And we are proud if we consider ourselves close to Fatima. Because of Fatima alayhi salam. Because she is the one who continues the progeny of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. But Fatima was not just a daughter. Fatima was one of the first believers in her father, Rasulullah. Fatima was one of the first supporters of Rasulullah. She was one of the first helpers for her father, Rasulullah. When the mushrikeen would harass Rasulullah in Mecca, Abu Jahl and the thugs, they would go and they would throw the stomach of a sheep on Rasulullah while he's doing sujood in Masjid al-Haram. Fatima would come and she would clean her father, even though she was very young. She would help Rasulullah. She would be there for her father, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, until her mother Khadija passed away. And it was Fatima, at a very young age, she took up the task of being like a mother to her father, Rasulullah, where she cared for Rasulullah so much until Rasulullah says about her, Fatima Ummu Abiha. Fatima is the mother of her father. In the battle of Uhud, Rasulullah was injured. Rasulullah was bleeding on his forehead. Rasulullah's teeth were broken in the battle of Uhud. It was Fatima that came and she began to heal the wounds of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. It was Fatima that had an active role in helping her father, Rasulullah, because of her faith, because of her ikhlas, because of her love towards Rasulullah. When the verse came down telling the Muslims, "O Muslims, do not call Rasulullah by his name Muhammad, call him Rasulullah." The first who took that up was Fatima. She began to tell her father, "Ya Rasulullah." So Rasulullah, he looked at her, he tells her, "O Fatima, this verse is not referring to you. This verse is referring to those who have no respect. Call me Abata, call me father. Because when you call me father, this makes me happy." She was the joy in the life of Rasulullah, where Rasulullah says about her, Fatima bahjatu qalbi wabnaha thamaratu fuadi. Fatima is the joy of my heart, and her sons, they are the fruits of my life. They are the fruits of my eyes. This was Fatima. The greatness of Fatima in the life of Rasulullah, where Rasulullah, he says about her in front of all of the Muslims, and this is narrated by Bukhari, where he says, "Inna Allah yarda li ridha Fatima wa yaghdabu li ghadabiha." Allah is satisfied by the satisfaction of Fatima, and Allah is angered by the anger of Fatima. What kind of a person was she that Allah is satisfied by her satisfaction and Allah is angered by her anger? This was Fatima alayhi salam. When the verse came down, وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنْ وَاجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. This was the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He used to say, رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنْ. Jibreel tells Rasulullah, the azwaj, the wives in this verse is Khadija. وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا is Fatima. قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنْ, joy for our eyes, those are Hassan and Hussein. وَاجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. That is Ali ibn Abi Talib, the Imam of the Muttaqeen. This is why It was only Ali ibn Abi Talib who was worthy to marry Fatima. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam, he says, if not for Ali ibn Abi Talib, Fatima would not have a kufu. Fatima would not have an equal counterpart. Many came and they proposed. Abu Bakr came and he proposed. Umar, he came and he proposed. Many of the rich and older sahaba, they came and they proposed to marry Fatima. Rasulullah would reject. And Rasulullah would say, the matter of the marriage of Fatima is not in my hands. Allah chooses who she marries. Until after all of the others, they came and they proposed. Amir al-Mu'mineen, he was shy. He was the first believer. But he has nothing. He left everything. His father passed away. He left everything. Now he is under the command of Rasulullah. He has a sword, he has an armor, and he has a mule. He comes to Rasulullah. Rasulullah begins the conversation. He tells him, لَعَلَّكَ جِئْتَ لِتَخْطُبْ فَاطِمَةً. Oh Ali, it seems that you have come to ask for Fatima's hand in marriage. So Amir al-Mu'mineen, he tells him, yes, oh Rasulullah. So Rasulullah tells him, what do you have? He says, I have a sword, I have a mule, and I have an armor. That's all that I have. Rasulullah tells him, we need your sword, O Ali. And you need the mule to work. Go and sell your armor. Allah will protect you. Go and sell it and let that be the mahar of Fatima. The mahar of Fatima was 500 dirhams. A very modest mahar for Fatima alayhi salam. This is why the hadith say that the real mahar of Fatima is the shafa'ah on the Day of Judgment. The real mahar is that Fatima will be able to pick her Shias and her lovers one by one. This is the real mahar of Fatima. Otherwise, no amount of monetary money is worthy of Fatima. But look at Fatima alayhi salam. She began that life with Amir al-Mu'mineen as the wife of Amir al-Mu'mineen. And she was equal to Amir al-Mu'mineen. She was equal. That equilibrium that was formed in that marriage between Amir al-Mu'mineen and Fatima, where it was full of love. A relationship full of compassion and love and respect towards one another. And it was a very simple marriage. Today you find many of the marriages, they're falling apart because of money. Fighting over money. The wife, the wife says, my husband is not giving me money. The husband, he's complaining about money when it comes to his wife. Money does not bring happiness, my dear brothers and sisters. Money is a tool, and we just use it to an extent until our life comes to an end. There are greater things in life that bring satisfaction. If you don't believe me, go and ask those who have a lot of money. Go and ask those who will tell you in first-hand experience, we have money, but it hasn't brought us happiness. If you have health, if you have iman, if you have akhlaq, that is what brings you happiness. If you have the love of Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad, that is what will bring you satisfaction. If you are content with what Allah has destined for you, then whatever you are living, in whatever status you have, even if you are poor or rich, you will be satisfied. Because Allah has chosen that for you. And you know that Allah chooses only the best for you. This was Fatima and this was Amir al-Mu'mineen. And this is why they lived in a marriage, in a relationship where they kept giving and giving. After the marriage, Rasulullah, he comes and he asks Amir al-Mu'mineen, how is Fatima? What kind of a wife is Fatima? So Amir al-Mu'mineen, he replies, he tells him, نَعْمَ الْعَوْنَ عَلَىٰ طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. Fatima is the best partner in worshipping Allah. Fatima is the best partner in bringing me closer to Allah. And this is what a real marriage is. A marriage that brings the two couple closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's okay if it starts off as a simple marriage. It's okay if you have a simple wedding. That's not what brings happiness, the wedding and the dress and all of these things. That sometimes some marriages begin, a relationship begins with the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is this how a family should begin? With the disobedience of Allah? Taking the first foot, the first step in disobeying Allah who has given us everything? Look at the marriage, the most fruitful marriage, the marriage of Amir al-Mu'mineen and Fatima. That marriage that bore the children of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a marriage of happiness. Even despite all the difficulties that Amir al-Mu'mineen was facing, the Muslims were going through difficult times. Those in the first stages, the first few years of the marriage, there were wars, there were battles. The Muslims are, they keep getting attacked. The Battle of Badr, Uhud, Hunayn, Khandaq, all of these battles. It was a very shaky time. Amir al-Mu'mineen, he says, when I would go and look at Fatima, I would forget all of my problems. One of the hadith that says, Fatima al-Zahra, summiyat al-Zahra. Zahra means the blooming flower. He says, summiyat Zahra li'annaha kanat tazhar li'amir al-mu'mineen. She is named the Zahra because she would bloom for Amir al-Mu'mineen when he looks at her. Just like a flower blooms. This is why Amir al-Mu'mineen, 30 years after the martyrdom of Fatima al-Zahra, he continues to remember Fatima. In the Battle of Safin, Ammar and the companions of Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen, they're dyeing their hair. So that day, Amir al-Mu'mineen, his beard is all white, it's all gray. So they tell Amir al-Mu'mineen, why don't you dye your beard? Why don't you dye your beard? Amir al-Mu'mineen, he tells them, أَنَا فِي حُزُنْ. I'm in mourning right now. They tell him, who are you mourning? Oh, Amir al-Mu'mineen. He tells them, حُزْنِي عَلَى الزَّهْرَاءِ. I'm mourning Fatima. A relationship where Amir al-Mu'mineen, he remembers her day and night. And this is what he says over the grave of Fatima after he buries her. He says, فَإِنَّ حُزْنِي سَرْمَدْ. My sadness is sarmad, it's forever, eternal. وَلَيْلِي مُسَهَّدْ. And my nights are sleepless after you, Fatima. This was the relationship of Amir al-Mu'mineen and Fatima alayhi salam, a relationship based on love and compassion and giving and mercy. She, Amir al-Mu'mineen, he himself, when they ask him, how come you continue to mourn Fatima? He says, فَوَاللَّهِ مَا أَغْضَبْتُهَا وَلَا أَكْرَهْتُهَا عَلَىٰ أَمْرٍ حَتَّى قَبَضَهَا اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. He says, I never angered her. And I never forced her to do anything that she does not like until she left this life. And then he says, وَلَا أَغْضَبَتْنِي. And she never made me angry. Imagine someone says that about his wife, a relationship where no one makes the other person angry. How many of us can do that? How many of us can try to control ourselves in a way where we don't make our partner angry with us? He says, وَلَا أَغْضَبَتْنِي وَلَا عَصَتْ لِي أَمْرًا. And never once did she disobey me. وَلَقَدْ كُنْتُ أَنظُرْ إِلَيْهَا فَتَنْكَشِفُ عَنِّي الْهُمُومُ وَالْأَحْزَانِ. And when I would look at her, I would forget all of my miseries and my problems. This was Fatima alayha salam. One day Amir al-Mu'mineen, he enters the house and he sees that there is no food in the house. So he tells Fatima, oh Fatima, we don't have food in the house. She tells him, no, oh Abul Hassan, we don't have food. He tells her, why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you tell me that there's nothing in the house? She tells him, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, I know you're a giving person. If you can bring, you bring. And if you can't bring, why should I make it more difficult upon you by asking you something that will make your life more difficult? So Amir al-Mu'mineen, he leaves the house and he goes and he borrows one dirham. He borrows one dirham, a silver coin, and he wants to go and buy some wheat so that they could make some bread, so that they could eat. As he is walking back home to do the shopping, he sees Al-Miqdad, his companion, one of the loyal Shi'as of Amir al-Mu'mineen. He sees Al-Miqdad. He tells Al-Miqdad, what are you doing right now during the day? No one should be out right now. Al-Miqdad, what are you doing? So Al-Miqdad tells him, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, I came out trying to bring food for my children and my family as well. So Amir al-Mu'mineen, he takes that dirham that he had borrowed and he gives it to Al-Miqdad. And he says, I'm going to go back home. My family is not going to cause a fuss. My family, they've slept hungry many nights for the sake of Allah. He goes back. He sees Fatima in the mihrab praying. And next to Fatima, there's a dish. There's a dish of food. So he asks her, he tells her, أَنَّا لَكِ هَذَا. Where is this from? She replies, "Huwa min 'indillah, inna Allah yarzuqu man yasha' bighayri hisab." The same reply that Maryam would answer Zakaria. This is from Allah. Allah brings the rizq bighayri hisab. So Rasulullah was standing. He tells Amir al-Mu'mineen, "Oh Ali, your Fatima is no less than Maryam." This was the relationship between Amir al-Mu'mineen and Fatima. She was the perfect wife. She was the perfect mother. Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam, he says, "I would see on a Thursday night, Laylatul Jum'ah, I would see my mother, she stands in the mihrab, the whole night she is doing dua for the neighbors. She's praying for the neighbors the whole night." So dawn approaches. I tell her, Imam al-Hasan says this, he says, "I tell my mother, oh my mother, I saw you the whole night, you've been praying for the neighbors." So she tells him, "Ya bunay al-jar, thumma al-dar." Oh my dear son, we do dua for the neighbor, and then we do dua for the home. And this is the sacrifice that the Ahlul Bayt learned from their mother Fatima. This is why Imam al-Hasan, he sacrifices his life for the sake of Islam. This is why Imam al-Husayn sacrifices his life for the sake of Islam. Because he has a mother like Fatima and a father like Ali. This was the role model. When you have a mother like that, of course you're going to be sacrificing. When you live in a household that sleeps hungry for 3 days, giving in the way of Allah, where Allah says, "Yufuna bin nadr wa yakhafuna yawman kana sharruhu mustatira wa yut'imuna at'ama ala hubbihi miskinan wa yatiman wa asira innama nut'imukum liwajhillah la nuridu minkum jaza'an wa la shukura." Say, we give you for the sake of Allah. We don't even want you to say thank you. At least sometimes when we give, we expect the other person to say thank you. The Ahlul Bayt, "La nuridu minkum jaza'an wa la shukura." And then Allah says the reward that they receive in Surah Al-Insan, which is the complete human being, and that is the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, until Allah says in the Quran, "Inna hadha kana lakum jaza' wa kana sa'yukum mashkura." Allah says all of the reward that the Ahlul Bayt receive. Now, something that scholars have pointed out is that when Allah speaks about paradise, oftentimes the Hur al-Ain, the mentioned. But in this part, the Hur al-Ain are not mentioned out of respect for Fatima. For the respect of Fatima, the Hur al-Ain are not mentioned in Surah Al-Insan. Because what are the Hur al-Ain in comparison to Fatima? This was Fatima, alayha salam, in her giving, in her worship. Look at Fatima in her worship. Another meaning for the name Zahra is that she was named Zahra because when she stands in her mihrab, she would create light. She would glorify and the light would come out of her face. This was Fatima alayhi salam. And even Aisha, the wife of the Prophet, and this has a Sunni source, she says that we used to, in the middle of the night, we used to place the needle, and the string in the needle, by the face, by the light of the face of Fatima. The light in the face of Fatima. And there is many hadith about this. The one who prays Salat al-Layl, he will have nur in his face. Amir al-Mu'mineen says this. Amir al-Mu'mineen says, "I never stopped praying Salat al-Layl from the day I heard Rasulullah saying, Salat al-Layl nur. Salat al-Layl is a light. Light in this life that shows you the way, and light in the afterlife, in the darkness of the afterlife, in the darkness of the grave, in the darkness of Qiyamah. Salat al-Layl will show you the way." And it was Fatima whose light was very apparent in this life. This is Fatima alayhi salam. She reached perfection in every aspect. When she was a daughter, when she was a wife, when she was a mother, when she was a worshiper, even when she went and fought for social justice. And this is one of the major lessons that we learned from Fatima. You want to be like Fatima? Go and stand against the oppressors. You want to be like Fatima? Speak against the zalim. This was what Fatima did. She defended the Quran. She defended Her husband, Amir al-Mu'mineen, and historians mention that Fatima came out and she spoke three times after the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. The first time was al-Khutbah al-Fadakiyah, the sermon which she gave regarding Fadak, the famous sermon of Fatima alayhi salam. Another time was when the women of the Muhajireen and the Ansar, they came and they visited her when she was sick. They came to visit her. We have the visit of the sick. It's mustahab. They came and they visit her. And she tells them very clearly on that day. She gave a sermon. She gave a speech to those women on that day. And she tells them, وَيْحَهُمْ, what was wrong with them? وَيْحَهُمْ أَنَّا زَحْزَحُوهَا عَنْ رَوَاسِ الرِّسَالَةِ وَقَوَاعِدِ النُّبُوَّةِ وَمَهْبَطِ الْوَحْيِ الْأَمِينِ والطبن بأمر الدنيا والدين ألا ذلك هو الخسران المبين. She tells them, what was wrong with your husbands? Why did they take the khilafah from Ali ibn Abi Talib after giving bay'ah to Ali ibn Abi Talib? Why did they move that what Rasulullah appointed and they came Abu al-Hasan? What was wrong with Ali ibn Abi Talib? وما نقموا من أبي الحسن نقموا والله منه نكير سيفه وشدة وطأته ونكال وقعته وتنمره في ذات الله عز وجل. She says, what was wrong with Abu al-Hasan? What did they not like against? What did they have against Ali ibn Abi Talib? And then she answers. She says, نقموا والله منه نكير سيفه. They hated him because of his sword on the battle of Badr and the battle of Uhud. It was Ali ibn Abi Talib who took out half of Quraysh. This is why they didn't like him. They didn't like him because of his justice, because of his ikhlas, because of his iman. This was Fatima defending Ali ibn Abi Talib. And the third time, Allama al-Amini in his book Al-Ghadir, he says that Fatima, she came out, she went knocking on the doors of the Muhajireen and the Ansar, reminding them of the Bay'ah of Ghadir. This was her whole task. She gave, she sacrificed all that she had for the sake of the imam of her time. Not because he was her husband, but because she believed in his imam. And Ali ibn Abi Talib believed in Fatima. They both were there for one another, protecting one another. And this was why Fatima gave up her life for the sake of Amir al-Mu'mineen. This was why Fatima cut her life very young. She could have stayed home. But for the sake of Imama, for the sake of the Quran, for the sake of the truth, she came out and she spoke against the injustice. And therefore they saw that the only way they silence her is to crush her between the door and the wall. And as a result of the injuries in which she sustained, she became weak and she became frail, where day after day she was getting weaker and weaker until she left this life. Asma bint Umays, she mentions, Imam al-Husayn, he mentions that Asma bint Umays, she would take care of Fatima and Ali ibn Abi Talib. He says, my father, he would go and take care of Fatima, heal the wounds of Fatima. He would be there for his wife Fatima, taking care of her, and Asma would also do the same thing. So after Fatima gave her wasiyah to Amir al-Mu'mineen, Asma bint Umays, she narrates, she says, I was with Fatima that day, the last day of her life. She got up and she washed the children, she washed her sons and her daughters, and she fulfilled all of her duties in the home. And she prepared food for her children, and then the children left the house. So Asma, she says, Fatima told me, oh Asma, I'm going to go in my room. I'm going to be reciting the Quran. If you notice that my voice has stopped, then know that I have left this life. So Asma says, Fatima, she entered into the room. She was reciting the Quran. I heard the recitation of the Quran, that beautiful recitation of Fatima, until suddenly that recitation came to a stop. I went in the room, I tell her, Ya bint Rasulullah, O daughter of Rasulullah, Ya Umm al-Hasanan, O mother of the Hasans. She did not answer me. Then a short while later, as I was in the room with her, I saw Hassan and Hussein. They came in the house. So I went to them, I rushed to them immediately, and I tell them, your mother has prepared food for you. She has prepared food for you. They tell me, oh Asma, when have you seen us eat without our mother Fatima? They wanted to go in the room. They went in the room. Imam al-Hasan, he throws himself on the body of his mother Fatima. And he begins to say, Ummah, kallimini qabla namut. Oh, my mother, answer me before I die. She says, Hussein, he threw himself on the feet of his mother Fatima. He began to kiss the feet of his mother Fatima. And he says, Ummah, oh my mother, kallimini, ana habibuki al-Hussein. I am the love of your heart, Hussein, answer me. Asma, she says, I came to them, I told them, O sons of Rasulullah, your mother has passed away, go and tell your father. So they ran into the masjid, they're crying as they run into the masjid. The Sahaba, they see them, they tell them, why are you crying, O sons of Rasulullah? Are you reminded of your grandfather, Rasulullah? They say, أَوَلَيْسْ قَدْ مَاتَتْ أُمُّنَا فَاطِمَا. Our mother Fatima has just passed away. Amir al-Mu'mineen, he hears what his sons had just said. He begins running to the house, calling out, Fatima, Fatima, Fatima. One narration says that Amir al-Mu'mineen fell on the ground when he heard what had happened to Fatima alayhi salam. Amir al-Mu'mineen, he enters the house. That day, the narrations say, it was a day like the day Rasulullah passed away. It was such a sad day in Medina. All of the Muslims, they gathered outside the house of Amir al-Mu'mineen and Fatima, waiting for the funeral. Then Abu Dhar, he comes out and he tells them, أُخِّرَ تَشِيعُ Fatima. The funeral of Fatima has been delayed. Go to your homes. And then, after it turned into night, لما نامت العيون وهدأت الأبصار, once it turned into night, Amir al-Mu'mineen, he came out to wash the body of Fatima because she had ordered him to wash her body in the middle of the night and bury her in the middle of the night. Asma says, I was pouring the water while Amir al-Mu'mineen was washing the body of Fatima, and Imam al-Hasan, he had a branch lit on fire so that they can see what they're doing. She says, as I was pouring the water, Amir al-Mu'mineen, he was wiping and washing the body of Fatima. She says, suddenly I saw him turn to the corner and he begins crying very loudly. I tell him, oh Abu al-Hasan, oh Amir al-Mu'mineen, why are you crying? We learn patience from you. What has happened to you, O Abu al-Hasan? He tells her, Ya Asma, لَقَدْ رَأَيْتُ ضِلْعًا مِنْ أَضْلَاعِهَا مَكْسُورًا. O Asma, I just saw something that she had hid from me this whole time. I just saw the bruises on her body. I just saw the broken rib of Fatima. After Amir al-Mu'mineen shrouded Fatima, he placed the kafan. He says, فَلَمَّا هَمَمْتُ أَنْ أَعْقُدَ أَزْرَارَ الْكَفَنِ. He says, before I wanted to tie the final knot of the kafan, I called the children. نَادَيْتُ يَا حَسَنْ يَا حُسَيْنْ يَا زَيْنَبْ وَيَا أُمَّ كُلْثُومْ هَلُمُّ وَتَزَوَّدُوا مِنْ أُمِّكُمْ. I called her children and I said, come and say your final farewell to your mother Fatima. فَهَذَا آخِرُ الْإِجْتِمَاعِ وَاللِّقَاءِ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. This is the last time you see your mother Fatima, and the next time is in paradise. Amir al-Mu'mineen, he says, they came and they threw themselves on the body of their mother Fatima. He says, they threw themselves on the body of their mother Fatima. He says, I swear by Allah, وَحَقِّ الْعَيْشِ الَّذِي عَاشَهُ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ أُشْهِدُ اللَّهِ
أنها حنت وأنت ومدت يديها إليهما وضمتهما إلى صدرها. He says, I swear by Allah, she reached her hands out of the kafan and she grabbed them. He says, I heard a caller calling from the sky, Ya Ali, O Ali, lift them, فَرَغَدْ وَاللَّهِ أَبْكَيَا مَلَائِكَةَ السَّمَاءِ Lift them, O Ali, they have made the angels of the sky cry. That night, after washing and shrouding Fatima in the middle of the night, a handful of Muslims, a few of the Sahaba, Salman, Al-Miqdad, Abu Dhar, Imam Al-Hasan, Imam Al-Husayn, they come out carrying the tabut of Fatima in the middle of the night to that hidden grave. They go to the grave, they pray the salah. Then Amir al-Mu'mineen, he tells Abu Dhar, he tells him, Oh uncle, Ya Am, Ya Aba Dhar, take Hasan and Husayn. I don't want them to see their mother being placed in the soil. So Abu Dhar and the companions, they leave Amir al-Mu'mineen alone with his wife Fatima. He carries her and he places her in that hidden grave. Narrations say that after Amir al-Mu'mineen buried Fatima, hajat bihi ahzano, his emotions overcame him. This man who is Asmar al-Sabirin, this man who is known for his patience, he could not tolerate, he could not hold himself when he was burying Fatima alayhi salam. As he was burying Fatima, he began to speak to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He says, As-salamu alayka ya Rasulullah, anni wa an ibnatika al-nazila fi juwarik, wa sari'ati al-lihaqi bik. قال يا رسول الله عن صفيتك صبري ورق عنها تجلدي. He says, peace be upon you, O Rasulullah. O Rasulullah, I have no patience for the loss of Fatima. And then he says, فلقد استرجعت الوديعة وأخذت الرهينة. This wadi'ah, this promise that you had given to me, you gave her to me in good shape. Now look at the way she is going back to you, O Rasulullah. And then he says, وَأَمَّا حُزْنِي فَسَرْمَدْ وَأَمَّا لَيْلِي فَمُسَهَدْ My morning is eternal and my nights are sleepless. إِلَىٰ أَنْ يَخْتَارَ اللَّهُ لِي دَارَكَ الَّتِي أَنْتَ بِهَا مُقِيمٌ Until I leave this life, I will continue mourning for Fatima. And then he tells him, he tells Rasulullah, وَسَتُنَبِّئُكَ ابْنَتُكَ بِتَظَافِرُ أُمَّتِكَ عَلَىٰ هَضْمِهَا فَأَحْفِهَا السُّؤَالِ وَاسْتَخْبِرْهَا الْحَالِ Ask your daughter Fatima what the Ummah did to her. Ask her the oppression that took place on her. And then, as he is ready to leave the grave, he says, وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمَا Peace be upon both of you. O Ali, and O Fatima, and O Rasulullah. سَلَامَ مُوَدِّعُ This is the final farewell. لَا قَالٍ وَلَا زَئِمٍ فَإِنْ أَنْصَرِفْ فَلَا عَنْ مَلَالَهِ وَإِنْ أُقِمْ فَلَا عَنْ سُوءِ ظَنٍ بِمَا وَعَدَ الصَّابِرِينَ If I get up from your grave, this is not because I am bored and I am tired from sitting over your grave. And if I stay, this is not because I have lack of faith in Allah when what Allah has destined the mu'mineen. Then Amir al-Mu'mineen, he walks back to his home, lonely, all alone. He has just buried Fatima, the love of his life. As he is walking back, he enters the home. His eyes fall on the door that hit Fatima. Once again, he is reminded of what happened to Fatima. He begins to call out, Nafsi ala zafaratiha mahbusatun. Ya laytaha kharajat ma'a zafarati. La khayra ba'daki fil hayat. Wa innama abki makhafata an tatula hayati. There is no khayr in this life. I cry because I will be living without you, Fatima. Ya Hussein.
Ya Hussein. Ya Hussein.
چیزی نیست من خوبم والسنات المذكوره ادمير فاطمه به علی اصلا قابل رسم نیست، جای عالم نمیشه با یه چیز مقایسه کرد، چیزی نیست آقا، چیزی نیست. اصلا نیازی نیست از بسترت پاشی با درد پیش پای شوهرت پاشی. ای گفتم از دردان هی گفتی چیزی نیست، گفتی اگه گاهی میفتی چیزی نیست، چیزی نیست. تو 18 سالت است چرا اینطور راه میری؟ تو دست به دیواری، گفتی یکم خسته، تو دست به دیواری، گفتی یکم خسته. دیدم قنوتت را، گفتی یکم دستم. این بچه ها سایه رو سر میخوان بارو، تا وقت دامادی مادر میخوان بار. از رفتن و از من کمتر بگی ای کاش، مادر میخواد زینب فکر عروسیش. چشم پراب تو نقش برابر کرد، تابوت تو اومد عجب، خاکی روی سرم ریخته، هم موی زینب هم خونم به هم ریخته. طفلی حسن هر شب تو خواب عزاداره، هی میگه دیواره، هی میگه گوشواره. زینب با دل شوره هی رو تو میبوسه، شونه که میفته بازو تو میبوسه. نگاهم تو نگاش افتاد، زمین که خورد همه عالم به پاش افتاد. امون ای دل، امون صدام میکرد،
نگاهم تو نگاش افتاد، زمین که خور همه عالم به پاش افتاد. امون ای دل، امون توی کوچه میونه اون همه نامه، خودش ای کاش کمر بند و رها میکرد. بسوز ای دل بسوز، حالا همه نوه خون بشن. بسوز ای دل که زهرا پای حیدر سوخت. بسوز ای دل، بسوز ای دل، بسوز. مگه میشد به آسونی رها از من؟ نگم دیگه چجوری شد جدا از من. امون ای دل، امون. از علی جدا نمی شد دنبال حیدر می دوید. محال بقیه‌ش رو بگم، فقط بدون دنبال حیدر میدویم. یه چیزی نباید میگفتم ولی میگم. میگن زن اگر طبیعی وضع هم کنه روز اول استراحت کنه، فردا کمکش کنن را بره براش خوبه. اما اگه یه زنی سقط کرد یه هفته بخوابه زهرا بلند شد دنبال حیدر میدوید، میدوید. بسوز ای دل که زهرا پای حیدر سوخت. بسوز ای دل که زهرا پای حیدر سوخت. بسوز ای دل که زهرا. مگه میشد به آسونی رها از من؟ نگم دیگه چجوری شد جدا از من؟ امون ای دل، امون. علی برگرد صداش تو گوشم انگار، علی برگرد امون از این در و دیوار. علی برگرد، علی برگرد، علی برگرد، صداش تو گوشم انگار علی برگرد امون از این در و دیوار امون اینه نوه بخون براش بسوز ایده که زهرای هیدر سوز بسوز بسوز ایده که زهرا روزمو خلاصه کنم گذشت گذشت علی یه روزی یاد خاطرات میکرد به هم گفتم به دیوار تکیه میداده به هم گفتم چجور رو خاکا افتاده من یه جمله بگم یا نه یه بار میدونی کجا رو خاکا افتاد اون جایی که خودش فرمود آتش زبانه میکشید صورت من میسوخت یه اتفاقاتی افتاد فسقط طول وجهی من با صورت به زمین خوردم یه بار دیگه هم میدونی چی شد یه اتفاقی افتاد که شاعر گفت به هر جا مادری از شوق دست طفل خود گیرد در این کوچه گرفته طفل دست مادر خود را مادر بلند شد به هم گفتن به دیوار تکیه می داده به هم گفتن چجور رو خاک افتاده همون عیده به هم گفتم نگاهش تار میدیده نگاهش تار میدیده دست عدو بزرگتر از صورت من بهم گفتن نگاهش تار می دیده بهم گفتن همش آزار میدیده امون ایده امون بسوز ایده که زهرا پای هیدر سوز بسوز ایده بسوز ایده بسوز حالا دو بندم از زبون بی بی بگم اون شبی که علی آمد کنار بسترش با هم شروع کردن گریه کردن امیرالمومنین فرمود چی شده؟ شروع کرد برای علی حرف زدن. حسن دیده حسن خیلی چیزا رو دیده، حسن دیده برای اینها چه ها کرده، چقدر واسه همین مردم دعا کرده. امون این دو بیت تو برای امام زمان میخونم، هر جا مجلس مادری باشه اگه پسر داشته باشه دم در میسته، همه بهش سر سلامتی میده، همه میگن آقا بقای عمر شما باشه، سرت سلامت. اونم مهربونی میکنه، از همه تشکر میکنه، یه قدم رنجه کردیم. آقا ما رو ببخش، حسن دیده توی کوچه زمین خوردم، حسن دیده چقدر واسه علی مردم. امون ایده امون ایده امون از غربت هیده، کجا رفتی دیگه کسی جواب سلام منو نمیده، کجا رفتی این مردم دیگه علی رو نمیخوان. کجا رفتی که تا آخر عمر میگفت خدایا من از اینا خستم، بند آخر روزم، ایشالله ما یه روزی میای مدینه برات بلند بلند گریه میکنی. دلم تنگه برا اون طفل شیش ماهه، دلم خونه خدا از حالم آگاهه. امون خدا حافظ، شبای غربت هیدر، خدا حافظ مدینه شهر پیغمبر، خدا حافظ خدا. امون ایده امون از غربت هیده، امون همه نوع خون بشن، نه از غربت هیده، روزمون تمومه. اما یا زهرا اگه به اسمت قسم بخورم که از الان نگران زیارت اربعینمم، گزافه نگفتم. سلام آقا که
که الان روبروتونم. من اینجامو زیارت نامه میخونم، حسین جانم. دلم کربلا میخواد، مدینه کرامون نمیدم. سلام آقا که الان روبروتونم. من اینجامو زیارت نامه میخونم، حسین جانم.
بذار سایت همیشه رو سرم باشه، قرار ما شب جمعه حرم باشه. چی شد دلمون کجا رفت شبهای جمعه فاطمه؟ با اضطراب و واهمه آید به دشت کربلا، آید به دشت نینوا، گوید حسین. من چه شبود بنایم قتلو کرد و هو کرد و من المان من او کرد. ده مرتبه دست تو به نشانه لبک بلند کن، صدا بزن یا حسین.
مگه یادم میره من بودم و یه گل پرپر؟ مگه یادم میره زخم روی فلت؟ مگه یادم میره خون آبه بال کبوتر؟ مگه یادم مگه یاد نابه باله بودم؟ مگه یادم میره من بودم و کوچه غمها؟ مگه یادم میره دستی سیاه که میره بالا؟ مگه یادم میره روی زمین ناله زهرا؟ مگه یادم میره من بودم و کوچه غمها؟
چه کوچه ای بود؟
مگه یادم میره دست سیاه که میره بالا؟ مگه یادم میره روی زمین ناله زهرا؟ مگه یادم میره من بودم و یه گل پرپر مگه یادم میره صورت مادر مگه یادم میره یه روز خون دائم بالا سر قبرش میخون از داغش میخون از صبرش منو بزنید مادرم و گل پر پر مگه یادم میره مخمه روی صورت مادر مگه یادم مال کبوته مگه یادم
بعضی ها دارن بالا میخونن
مگه
بعضی ها دارن جز میزنن روزن
صورت مادر مگه یادم میره اون آبه باله کبوتر مگه یادم میره من بودم و یه گل پر پر مگه یادم میره زخم روی
آجابا خونم من یه خط یه بند بخونم برای امام حسن دلت ماند حضرت مادر دو غم به دلت ماند حضرت مادر کفن برای حسین حرم برای مگه یادم میره بخونین شاید شب جمعه دیگه کربلا بودی امام حسن ببره کربلا مگه یادم میره من بودم و یه دل شاکی مگه یادم میره من بودم و شادر خواهد مگه یادم میره اون کوچه و آتیش و هیزو مگه یادم میره اون خنده های تلخ من
تو باشه ریکه خود دم آخر آقات میسوزی مدینه تو باشه ریکه خود دم آخر آقات میسوزی به آینش روز آخر گفت مثل روز تو نیست هیچ روزی امام حسن خودش دلا رو برده به کربلای حسین، امام حسن خودش دلا رو برده به کربلای حسین، بخشید روزه خودشو به عشق روزهای حسین، کریم عالم بود و گذاشت دار و ندارشو برای حسین، با جگر پاره با اون تن بی حال میخون از مقتل میخون از گودار، ای کشته دور از وطن دور از وطن دور از وطن دور از وطن، ای کشته دور از وطن دور از وطن دور از وطن.
تو سر شد حال من خوبه، تو روزه بهتر شد، من تو چشم تو خدا رو می دیدم، هر دفعه آقا چشای من تر شد، برای مادرت اگه خون ببارم کمه، فاطمیه برام مثل ماه محرمه، فاطمیه برام مثل ماه محرمه، برای مادرت اگه خون ببارم کمه، فاطمیه برام مثل ماه محرمه، فاطمیه برام مثل ماه محرمه. ای جان ای جان جان جانان، ای عشق ای شور و روح و ریحان، ای جان ای جان جان جانان، ای عشق ای شور و روح و ریحان، به مادرت قسم صدام بزن، منو ببر کربلام ببین که بارونه چشای من، منو ببر کربلام فقط به خاطر امام حسن، منو ببر کربلام منو ببر کربلام منو ببر
دستا بیاد بالاها.
آدم عیسی تو ذکر مسیحا تو، شور شیرینم زلف چلیپا تو، قبله عشقی حضرت سلطانی، روح ایمانی ساکن دلها تو، تو دست رد نمیزنی روی این سینه ها، دلم میخواد بیام شب جمعه ها کربلا، دلم میخواد بیام شب جمعه ها کربلا، تو دست رد نمیزنی روی این سینه ها، دلم میخواد بیام شب جمعه ها کربلا، دلم میخواد بیام شب جمعه یارم، عشق تو کار و بارم یارم، من خیلی دوست دارم یارم، عشق تو کار و بارم یارم، من خیلی دوست دارم، به مادرت قسم صدام بزن ببین چه بارونه چشای من منو ببن فقط به خاطر امام حسن منو ببر کربلا منو ببر کربلا منو ببر
لباس مشکی تو بپوش فاطمیه فصل از آس لباس مشکی تو بپوش شهیدامون دارن میرسن پرچم مشکی روی دوش از عرش خدا نوای روزها بود دلا پر خون چه شاخی سپارونن در و دیوان دارن روزه میخونن میدای پهلو شکست گریونن میخونن همه اهل کائنات حب و فاطمه طریق و نجات حب و فاطمه
همه گوشه کنار همه سینه دن باشن
حب و فاطمه
همه دیز سوتوسون در گربا
حب و فاطمه شهیدامون دارن میرسن پرچم مشکی روی دوش میرسه از عرش خدا نوای روزها به گوش دلا پر خون چه شاخی سپارونن در و دیوان دارن روزه میخونن شهیدای پهلو شکست گریونن میخونن همه اهل کائنات حب و فاطمه طریق و نجات فاطمه فرزند تو میون ظلمت تشنه طلوع لبخند تو اسیر ماجراهای لطف گلو بند تو میخوان باشم سپاه
باشن تو پناه تو، کم از شمشیر نبود تیغ آه تو، جون مرتضا جونمون فدا، حب و فاطمه تریق ججای حیدر و دست پرستو میگیره، چی شده که زهرا توی خونمونم رو میگیره، مادر کشتی نجات شکست پهلو میگیره، اگر سوختیم اگر چه شکست پهلو نشد کم از سر مرتضی یک مو، تو الگوی ابو فاضلی بانو میزنن صدا موجای فرات، حب و فاطمه
طبقت فكر اليهود صفوا قتل ابليس وصارت جنود، الله يلعنهم لعن عاد وثمود، الله يلعنهم لعن الله يلعنهم لعن عاد وثمود، لعنة السبت على من خان العهود، لعنة السبت على من بالحشر ماكو لهم مغفرة، لعن الله قاتل لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة، لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة، لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة، لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة، الله يلعن من حرق باب الرسول، هلا هلا الله يلعن من حرق باب الرسول، الله يلعن من كسر ضلع البتول، الله يلعن الله يلعن من كسر الله يلعن كل من يقلهم قبول، الله يلعن كل من يقلهم قبول، ولي خاف كلمة الحق ما يقول، ولي خاف للنبي شي يقول يوم المحكمة، للنبي شي يقول يوم المحكمة، لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة، إيه لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة، لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة،
لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة،
لعن الله قاتلك
فاطمة، لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة، لعن الله قاتلك فاطمة.
باشه.